Are you looking to brighten somebody's eyes in Lightroom? Well, this tutorial will go over some tips and tricks and some things that I learned while doing photo shoots and whatnot on how to brighten the eyes. So we got this image right here. I actually was like looking for somebody, and Julia here is an absolutely amazing model. Literally love working with her. But we're gonna brighten up her eyes a little bit. And this is pretty much straight out of camera. I didn't edit it or do anything really. And this was actually a campaign shoot for Lorena Sparkling Soda, which if you see it in the story, go check it out. It's a pretty cool brand. But let's get into the video here. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna kind of look at what it looks like. Now you can skip ahead to actually the actual part where I start using the brushes, but what I like to do is kind of focus and understand what is going wrong with this right here. So as you can see, I did a video on the histogram on my other channel if you guys want to check that out, but as you can see, we can see the histogram up here and there is a lot of whites, but it's also, we also don't have too many shadows in here as well, and a lot of it is skewed more on this side, the like 75 percentile, where we would want to be more like this. And if you did something like this, where it was brighter all the way over here, you would obviously get a different photo and it'd be complete washed out. And that was just because of the sun, and and the direction that we were in, the sun was actually up pretty high. So this isn't one of the worst photos for as far as the eye goes, but let's check it out. So I want to say this was downscaled, but it doesn't look like it was downscaled. So what I'm going to do, we're in Lightroom, we're in the, what edition is this? We are in the 2022 build. Build is right there if you want to know what build we're in. I would highly recommend getting the new Photoshop. They just updated their tools. So we're going to go in here and let me go back a step. So we're going to add new mask. We're going to go down here past the add new mask section into the brush. And you just want to use the brush because there's not really anything else that we can do at this point. So we're going to lightly do this. Now there are a couple different ways that you can do this. There's also a selective brush. And as you can see, I had auto mask on. Now this is the settings that I had when I first went over. This usually works, feather 100, flow 76. This is, 76, density 100. So I'll go over these real quick. So the size is basically just your size, and you can adjust this with the bracket keys. And then the feather is this other part right here on the brush where it will kind of soften the edges. So I like bringing that all the way up and just adjusting my size. And then flow is basically how much like opacity in a way you want on it. However, the opacity gets stacked. It's not like absolute throughout the whole thing. So, and then density is like the opacity as well. So let's see, let's go down here, and this was auto mask. So what I'm gonna do is, now instead of going, and so as you can see, it's red right now, and that's because I have that option set. You can obviously turn this off. It's in one of the settings, so there's a before and after if you look at that. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna actually change the settings here. So as you can see, you already can bring up and change the eye. Now I'm not going to do that for you guys because I know that's an injustice, so don't do that. A lot of tutorials are probably not going to lead you down that direction, so no worries there. But what we're going to do instead is bring up the highlights, and then we're going to also bring up the whites a little bit. Now if you're going for that HDR look, you can also bring up the shadows, but I wouldn't recommend it. I would say that the human eye also looks like, when you're a viewer, you look at the eye almost immediately, so you don't want it to look too fake. And the eye, when a viewer is looking at it, they'll be able to tell if it is too much or not. And that can really change the way a photo feels. And that all comes down to our artistic style. But as you can see, we did both eyes here. Now, I'm not a huge fan of doing both eyes actually at once. So we're gonna just leave it at that one. And then we're gonna go in here and we're gonna create a new one. Brush, and we're going to do the same thing over on this side. It's this. And as you can see, this is the overlay mode, color overlay. And I have it set to red because I like red. And we're not gonna do the exposure. I kind of like doing that sometimes just to see what it looks like and if I got the right spots or not. So we're gonna brighten that up. That's good. This one's good. This one I feel like should be a little bit lighter. And then we're going to, now you can press your back key and you can kind of see the difference right there. So as you can see, it's pretty noticeable when you're up close, but when you're far away, it's less noticeable. Now I do think that this side on this side, so we're gonna bring we're gonna actually create a new brush, and we're gonna bring this. We're gonna bring this side up a little bit. Now I know it is shadowed, so you wanna be careful with that, but you can still bring up the highlights here and the whites. And then you can also bring up the shadows, and there you go. And we're just going to, let me see what I got here. So it's just that section right there. And then we're gonna zoom out, and it's very unnoticeable, but it's that subtlety that really changes the whole entire photo. And dude, this photo just makes me wanna smile, honestly. This was such a nice day to do this photo shoot. But yeah, so that's how you brighten up the eyes in Photoshop. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to check out, I actually think I did a video doing this photo shoot. So if you wanna go check that out, leave a like, leave a comment that you're from this video. That'd be awesome. But a really fun time shooting this with Julia. So go like this video if it was helpful. Go check out the other videos on this channel. There's a couple different ones on Lightroom. And I will see you guys in the next video. See you guys later.